going on, peeps? You're here with Nate, and this is Crosspiece Production. And today I want to talk about my opinion on the new Studio One 6 upgrade, or I should say update to Studio One. Some of the things I'm pretty impressed by, I guess I'm happy that they're, you know, still progressing with the DAW. They're still, you know, implementing things that should be implemented, and they're listening to the crowd when it comes down to feedback. I would say they do that probably about 80% of the time, because some of the things I was just shocked to see. And no offense to Studio One, I really love the DAW. And if you see on my project list here, if you go right to the bottom, I've got a project in Studio One 5 from about 5 years ago. And that's not even when I started on Studio One. I started back when number 2, I believe, came out, Studio One version 2. And then I really started digging into it in version 3. All of my tutorials, you know, my channel was kind of built on this platform. A lot of these sort of tutorials were built on Studio One. So I will catch flack about this, I'm sure, though, in having comments about certain things. But I wanted to bring up some of the new updates and some of the things that I was a little bit shocked by, which were one of these, the vocoder. I don't know. I don't know if it's worth the upgrade for a vocoder. And hear me out. A long time ago, I did mention and I caught a lot of flack for it. People were like on the fence, on my side and on the other side, throwing flaming arrows at me as well, about the fact that I talked about a pitch correction plugin that I felt like they should have that in Studio One. And then when they brought this version out, I was like, surely they're going to bring it out. But no, they gave us the vocoder. I don't know if I'm ever going to use a vocoder. I'm sure that I could use a vocoder in Isotope plugins if I wanted one in the vocal effects plugin. I'm not complaining. I'm happy to see it and I like additions. But don't get me wrong on this one. I still want to see a pitch correction plugin at some point, please. That would be fantastic. Presonus and Studio One. I'd love to see that. Some of the features that I do, and I still, you know, I probably would never use them, but some of the features that I do really like, about Studio One that they update, the update contained, I should say, was the vocal, adding your vocals or your text vocal into the actual DAW and then having it follow along with MIDI or audio. That's kind of cool. I like the way that works. You know, they've still got Impact XT. They've still got all this stuff here. So I'm just going back right to the top, actually. I just want to kind of go through some of these things with you guys. Audio advanced editing, that's been advanced since the day dot, 4, 3, whenever you want to go back to it. But now it's really, you know, starting to really get high quality audio editing. So if you were coming from a DAW, any other DAW, for example, Pro Tools, and you were merging to Studio One, for example, maybe this upgrade would be worth it to you. If you're currently on 5, like I am, professional version, I'm really on the fence about whether or not I should upgrade. And again, I've been in this DAW for a long time and I do like Studio One. I like Presonus as a company. 64-bit recording, that's cool. Happy to see that. That was back when 5 was around as well. Some of these things, you know, the plugins, they were kind of there already. So just scrolling through briefly here. They have made some things addition-wise to the sends, and I like the way that the aux sends work now. And I'll show you some of that in the video now as well. And I also like how the bigger screen on the sends as well, so you can see what's going on with your plugins. I like that. I do appreciate the fact that they did that. So the channel overview is what they call it here. That is one of the things that I do like. They improved the browser. That's okay, whatever. That's fine. The browser was okay as it was already, but I guess if they're improving it, excellent. The quarter tool, I still feel like this needs to be changed, where you can add in a MIDI instrument in prior to your VST instrument, like you can in Logic. So you can add an actual VST MIDI instrument. So it's like, for example, scalar. You can put that prior to the actual sound of your VST, whatever that might be, Omnisphere, whatever it is, a piano, whatever sound you have. You can add it prior to that and then play as if you are using that MIDI instrument, like a keyboard or whatever, prior to the MIDI going in. So you can actually play the MIDI in, which Quarter can do this sort of stuff, but it's not the way that Logic works. And I still am hoping that they, you know, change it around a bit to be similar or exactly the same as how Logic is. And then I'll be like fully convinced that I don't need Logic. I still really like Logic, the way some things work, and when I get to it as well, I think to do with the binarial pan, that's been in Logic for a while now. And I kind of feel like it's a little bit disappointing that you have to pay for an upgrade just to have something that's already in another door that's been around for a while. You don't pay, I don't know when the last time is I paid for Logic. They just keep upgrading it though. And eventually they will charge you, but I'm just saying. The De-esser, it is what it is. People, I did tutorials on this a long time ago about de-essing with the multiband compressor, and I'm sure a lot of other people did that as well. But now they brought out a specific de-esser. You know, got a clap on the hand for that one. I'm just saying, like, you know, the de-esser kind of should have been there a while back. But anyway, they brought that out, and that's an upgrade in number 6. I really got to say, you know, the inspector, as far as improving that, they should really be aiming to do that anyway, regardless of a upgrade to 6. You know, it's good that they're doing that and they're pointing that out, I guess. But, you know, that should be already on their books as a plan. And the lyric support, which is a new add-on, which allows you to put lyrics in notation and also with MIDI and audio. I guess that's kind of cool. That's a good feature to have. Again, I think that would be useful for some people, especially if you're writing songs or, you know, creating content like that. They really should have more than just panning, and they should have had this a while back anyway with a binarial pan, balance dual, and, you know, all that stuff, because, you know, for example, Logic has that and other doors have that sort of stuff as well. And Logic also has Dolby Atmos mixing, which you can do in the door, which I think is crazy. They added that for free. There was no charge, but Studio One are charging for panning. Don't get me wrong. Again, this is not a bash at Presonus. It's most certainly not a bash at the company itself or the product. I really just feel like they should step it up a little bit when they do updates. You know, all of that's in Studio One. There's a few other things, and I might upgrade to this door later on. I feel like I'll probably, you know, when it comes down to it, I probably will. You know, focus on more, I guess, getting back to the grassroots of listening to the customers, implementing things that the customers are asking for. And maybe the customers are asking for these things. I don't know. I certainly, some of these things I was, you know, just a little bit shocked by, but it is what it is. You go through that. With the Pro EQ, I'm happy to see that they've got dynamic EQ in a door, because, you know, that's very useful. Again, I go and use Isotope plugins for their dynamic stuff, but there you go. You have a really good EQ, which you can now sidechain and do all kinds of good stuff with that. And, you know, as it goes on, the list keeps following on. I don't want to keep going with this video too long, but hopefully you get an idea. Do I feel like it's worth the upgrade at this stage? The upgrade, if you're on 5, I would say maybe wait a little bit to see if it's worth your while. If you're on 4 or prior to that, definitely probably worth the upgrade, because you're getting all this stuff. Pipeline XT was upgraded, I think, at 4 or 3.5. I can't remember exactly. But, it, you know, if you're going to go from there to here to 6, definitely worth the upgrade for that sort of stuff and all the other things you're getting here. At the moment, if it was $100, maybe I'd consider it. If it was less than that, 100%, I would. But as far as the upgrade to $150 almost, or $146, whatever the exact amount is, it's pushing the envelope a little bit. Again, if you're coming from other doors though, you know, your Pro Tool, your other door, whatever it is you're using, and you like Studio One, you've tried it out previously and it works for you, yeah, sure. Take the plunge, $399 or whatever the near price to that is. It's definitely probably worth it for you. And I'd say that this is a good upgrade for anyone who hasn't used the door in the past either. So definitely check this out. If it's something of interest, hopefully it gave you a bit of information and my opinion as well. But as always, love you guys and peace.